this demonstration, we're going to be focused on data center and private cloud management, specifically with a new technology we've introduced in System Center 2012 SP1 we call Global Services Monitor. Now, Global Services Monitor is an example of our comprehensive monitoring and deep application insight that System Center 2012 SP1 provides. It enables a rich end-to-end scenario from the creation of web tests to the external outside-in monitoring, integrating on-premise monitoring and rich developer diagnostics in the case of any detected exceptions. Now, on-premises, you have developers working in Visual Studio 2012. Visual Studio enables our developers to create web tests to validate that their applications are functioning correctly. A subset of these tests would then be imported into Operations Manager, which is subsequently used to configure the Global Service Monitor service. Now, Global Service Monitor is actually a service hosted in our Windows Azure points of presence around the globe that enables organizations to assess the real-world performance and availability of their applications. Operations Manager instructs Global Service Monitor which application endpoints to invoke with the web test along with a schedule. Once configured, Global Service Monitor calls the production web application according to the schedule and returns the results to the on-premise Operations Manager for display along with other monitoring data on the application gathered within the organization's private network. This capability ensures the broader set of data to assess the health of an application and when intervention is necessary. When Global Services Monitor returns either an exception or response times that trigger an alert in the Operations Manager, Operations Manager can schedule a work item to be added to the developer's queue to be addressed by that developer. This level of integration helps to accelerate issue resolution and achieve SLAs. Now let's take a look at this new technology. System Center 2012 SP1 Operations Manager can now show you different perspectives of an application health in one place. We call this the 360.NET Application Monitoring Dashboards. Now, the Application Monitoring Dashboards can actually display information from Global Services Monitor, as well as the .NET Application Performance Monitoring and Web Application Availability Monitoring to provide a summary of health and key metrics for three-tier applications in a single view. The 360.NET Application Monitoring Dashboards show where an application is unhealthy and also provides a launch point for the detailed dashboards that highlight component level issues. Now, as we mentioned before, Global Services Monitoring monitors the availability of applications from an outside applications, measuring the availability from where the user is. So let's go and now configure GSM as part of our Operations Manager environment and show how this can feed data into the application dashboards view as we see here. Now, I can access GSM through a number of ways, including the authoring and administration. In this case, I'm going to be showing GSM through the new GSM administration wizard. However, you can both create and modify tests in the authoring view as well. Now, what you'll see here is we can actually both configure a web application availability test. We can also configure Visual Studio web tests for much more customized synthetic transactions. So as your developers are creating web tests to test the performance of their applications through the dev cycle, load them in utilizing this wizard into our Azure Points of Presence and test the user experience globally for that application. So I'm going to configure a basic web application availability test through this wizard. Now, this wizard brings up a number of monitoring types which I can select for our needs, but we'll continue using the web application availability monitoring. In here, I just simply enter the name of the GSM test that I want to run and then select a partnering management pack. In fact, I've got a Dinner Now management pack which we've created to support this application. Next, I'm going to choose what to monitor. And in this case, I can actually monitor multiple URLs as part of the single test. So if I'm hosting multiple versions of my application in different regions, or I want to monitor various applications or various parts of the application itself, I can simply add the name and the URL as part of this tool. In this case, we're just going to simply write in our Dinner Now and send it off to our Dinner Now URL. Next, I can now set up various GSM monitoring points based on our global Azure locations to monitor the customer experience of my application. I simply hit Add and Search, and it will show me all the Azure points of presence I can use in GSM. In this case, you can see they're all the way around the world, and I'm going to select them all. You know, I can also use GSM to monitor from internal locations and servers too. In fact, here I'm just going to click the Add button again and search for servers that I can use as monitoring stations for internal needs. Here I'm going to select my first one on the list, and now I'm set to monitor the customer experience of my application from both Azure GSM points of presence globally as well as internal applications. But what are we actually monitoring? We have a number of configuration choices available as part of our monitoring view. Now, by default, we're monitoring for all site down alerts, which we can also configure as needed. But that's not all. We have a large number of customizations we can perform on our GSM test, including transaction response time, HTTP code status, and even content matching. In this case, let's also monitor for application performance. So I want to be alerted if my application fails to respond within 1.5 seconds. All I do is simply add this in here and click the Apply button, and now that test is then modified. Now let's look at what other customizations are available. You know, one example is we can actually customize the alert collection to ensure we're ignoring small blips in the performance or availability, maybe due to some random network congestion, by selecting to be alerted if multiple errors are detected at a specific time range. We can also collect various forms of data such as response time, time to first byte, content size, and so on. We can also add in monitoring for HTTP headers and proxy server settings as needed as well. So now we see a summary of our test, and all we do is simply click on the Create button to start that test. Now during that time, our test parameters will be loaded into our Azure GSM points of presence, and our monitoring will begin. Alright, now let's take a look at some of the existing GSM tests which we've already configured. Our initial view shows the location and quick glance view of the health in a simple data list. Here you can easily see that while most of our internal and external monitoring sites are healthy, we have two sites showing critical alerts. And we can actually delve a little deeper into understand the issues better utilizing our fully integrated GSM and System Center 2012 Operations Manager tools. First, let's look at the detailed dashboard report for our application. Here I simply choose the location I want to know more information about and the test that I want to explore. In one simple view, I can see all the captured data for my application from that exact point of presence. This gives me a valuable information in tracking down any issues. I also have another great report which I want to show you before we delve down deeper into understanding the application error from the Azure Moscow monitoring site. Now the GSM dashboard map view also provides me a great way to see the health of an application from the various Azure GSM monitoring sites. I can also add my internal sites to this map view as well. So with a simple glance, I can see healthy and unhealthy responses no matter where they are in the world. Now let's see what's happening with my application from the Moscow region. I simply choose Moscow on the map. And now I have the full power of my System Center 2012 Operations Manager tools to troubleshoot this alert. Now I want to view the exact alert information in my alert viewer. I simply select it from my tasks, and it will show me all the alerts that are currently applicable to that site. In this case, I have a single one. And looking at the alert details, you can see my transaction response time was over 21 seconds. In this case, it's showing me that it's exceeded my response time SLA. I can also understand that this is an ongoing issue, or maybe a new one, by looking at my Health Explorer information. Here it's showing me the alerting information that is being captured via my management pack. And the inbuilt knowledge, both out of the box and customized as needed, so I can understand this error more. I can also track the history of this error via my Change State Events view, and again, all the information about this is at my fingertips. Now, while a simple example, you can see the power of GSM and its integration with System Center 2012 Operations Manager to monitor, alert, and react on application customer experiences throughout the world. No longer am I limited to my testing internally, or need to use expensive and largely one-off custom testing in global environments. I can now use the power of my Azure-based global monitoring for my application monitoring and even use my own customized web tests unique to my application. Thank you.